On the wall! Can you hear them? Scurrying around! I'm scared! I'm really scared of them!
You've got nothing to be scared of. You're dead.
I know! Even back when I was alive, I saw dead people light up!
I gotta keep moving.
Keep your eyes peeled! They're even tormenting the dead! I've seen it! I've seen it!
Sorry, but I really don't want to hear this right now. Holy shit. Where did all these monsters come from?
A mere hypothesis.
Charles, I'm in the hot shop. Am I gonna turn into a crispy critter if I stay in here too long?
No, the laboratory tables in the hot workshop or thermarium require high temperatures. But the temperature within the shop itself is quite comfortable.
Thank you.
Wow. This place looks like no one's been here in a decade.
It could be due to a malfunction in the gravitational modulation system, or excessive polymer fertilizer production.
Thank you. your shift schedule carefully. An extra minute spent at lunch is a minute stolen from the people.
Hot as balls in here. You call this comfortable?
The temperature in the shop seems to have risen to an extremely high level.
Got it.
The hot workshop for Thermarium is one of the Babylon complex's most challenging and difficult to maintain. Specialized energy-consuming polymers and the breeding of
like they're about to blow. What the hell are we supposed to do?
I have no data. I've never been here before.
Okay. I'll deal with it. The boiler's too hot to touch. I need to find a way to cool it off from the inside. Okay, I found the opening. I've seen that stuff before. It's cryogenic, right?
Indeed, it is. That is a Fahrenheit, a candle filled with cryopolymer. It's designed to reduce temperatures and equalize pressure in high-temperature furnaces.
I'll try getting them into the boilers. How do I get into the pipe? What do I do now? Lug this shit to the boiler myself? In here. You call this comfortable?
The temperature in the shop seems to have risen to an extremely high level.
Got it. They must be in a room somewhere around here.
Located at the back and at the bottom of the assembly. You find these either along its central axis or on the inside of its wheels. The central portion.
Repeat. Attention employees who have recently been in contact. follow-up announcement a week later.
Damn, you're ugly! Freaking critters. This place just keeps getting more and more fucked up. You are there. mine, you sons of bitches.
Hey! Hey! Can you finish me off, please?
What the? Just wait for a medic, okay?
The entire facility has gone tits up, and who knows when the rescue team are going to be here. But I'm hurting right now. I'll never walk again anyway.
What makes you think the whole place has gone tits up?
If this happened in Vavilov alone, people from other complexes would be here already. It's happening everywhere, isn't it obvious?
Maybe there's a way to lift this thing. Give me a sec, okay?
There were three of us.
Right. I'll try to figure something out.
Just be quick. It hurts.
Remember to save the results of your experimental data and clear your workspace at the end of your shift.
You sure? Good thing the pipe's opening's in the next room, and not over by the birch tree. All set. Who the hell came up with all this shit? I'm sick to death of shoving balls into tubes.
We're doing this so we can leave the Vavilov complex.
Why can't I just, I don't know, walk out a regular door?
I'm afraid only an irregular door is available.
God, what a relief.
Comrade Major?
Yes? Got something constructive to say?
Have I done something to offend you? Why are you taking your frustration out on me?
Sorry. It's not your fault. I'm just mad at myself.
Why? You didn't kill Petrov. He was killed by his own weapon, a hostile robot.
That doesn't matter. I was supposed to take him alive, and I failed. And that's not all. Sechenov saved my life. He's like a father to me. As far as I can remember, anyway, I let him down.
If that's what's troubling you, just let it go. There's nothing unusual about your situation.
What do you mean?
Isn't it obvious? Comrade Sechenov is always disappointed in everyone. There's no pleasing the man. His perfectionism is pathological, and everyone knows it. Every single person in his life lets him down.
What? That's bullshit.
Neuropolymer gloves are incapable of deception.
Yeah.
Saving data.
I guess so.
Attention. Remember that illicit possession and dissemination of experimental data constitutes a crime against the Communist Party and is punishable by capital punishment.
Receiving data.
What's the hot workshop used for?
Heat-resistant polymers are made here. But most of the research is dedicated to the cultivation of heat-resistant flora.
Nice.
The polymers here are enriched with essential oils from Cacti cereris, a cactus. The polymers make it possible to cultivate groups of plants that are adapted to high temperatures.
Do they want to make the desert greener or something?
Something like that. They plan to terraform Mars. Canisters fill automatically once the temperature is normalized.
Everything here seems pretty cut and dry. We should head back before something fucked up happens.
Comrade Major, have you found Dr. Filatova yet?
The one who helped Petrov butcher hundreds of people? No. She's still crawling around somewhere.
I emphasize that Dr. Filatova must not be hurt. If her life is threatened, you must come to her defense.
What? Rescue the bitch whose fault it is I'm wading knee-deep in gore? What the fuck?
Traitor Petrov used Dr. Filatova without her knowledge. She had no inkling of his true intentions. I mean, the viciousness of this homicidal maniac. Her guilt must be established by a court of law.
Too good for her.
She deserves no less. Dr. Filatova is a renowned neural surgeon. Dr. Sechenov entrusted her with the collective research that connected both humans and robots. She must not be hurt. Did I make myself clear, Comrade Major?
I'll keep it in mind.
Back and at the bottom of the assembly. You find these either along its central axis